Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk to you guys about the week that I spent eating gluten. Normally I don't eat gluten. I have been diagnosed with an autoimmune disease, and it's called Pemphigus vulgaris, and it is a blistering disease of the skin and of the mouth. I get blisters in my mouth as well, but mostly I get them like on my skin, on my scalp. My upper body really is mostly where I get them. And so what I had decided that I wanted to do to minimize my chances of a flare-up was that I decided to lower the intake of things that cause inflammation. And I know that gluten can cause inflammation, intestinal inflammation, or just even inflammation in a lot of people. And just like dairy can, gluten can, let's see, why no sugar, things like that. I've tried to eliminate them from my lifestyle. And so I decided to go gluten-free. I actually decided to do this a really long time ago when I was diagnosed, which was in like 2013. But I'm not perfect, and I have gone on and off of gluten. And I know when I was pregnant, I had some regular bread and stuff like that. But then this last time when I had my son, he is almost 8 months now. This last time I decided that I was going to go back on gluten-free, and I have been, on gluten-free, but I decided to do a whole week of eating gluten to see if it would actually even make a difference. Because I mean, I love bread, you know, I love pasta, I love bread. I love Mexican bread. So I really wanted to see if it even made a difference, because I don't want to be sacrificing eating bread if it's not even going to do anything, you know? So I spent a whole week eating gluten after I had spent quite a few months after I had my son. And so this is what I found out. So day one, the first thing that I wanted to do was eat donuts. And so day one, I went and I had some Krispy Kreme donuts. They were delicious. I love Krispy Kreme donuts. And so I had donuts in the morning-ish. I mean, it was probably like 10. And so I also don't normally eat sugar anytime like in the morning like that. So I had the sugar and I had the carbs and the gluten. And so I know that day I didn't really feel anything. I think that mostly what I felt was like a little bit bloated, a little bit more full than when you're just eating less carbs and less sugar. So the next day, I know that in the morning when I woke up feeling very like groggy, like my head was kind of hurting. It wasn't really hurting, but I just really didn't feel so well. I didn't feel great. And I knew right away that it had to do with the gluten, because like I said, I've done this before where I've gone periods of time without eating gluten and then eating gluten. Like usually whenever I would break my gluten time or my gluten-free would be when it was my birthday, and I would buy a cake, and I love chocolate cake. And so every time for my birthday, we would kind of always break our diet because I would eat regular cake for my birthday. So I know what it feels like, and I know that the next morning when I woke up, I definitely had kind of like a gluten headache type. It wasn't strong, like it wasn't such a big headache, but it was definitely there. So I ate grilled cheese that next day. I love grilled cheese, and my sister had been eating it, and I would eat it with my gluten-free bread that I normally eat. I have made grilled cheese with my gluten-free bread, but I wanted to have a grilled cheese sandwich with regular bread, regular white bread with gluten, and it tasted delicious. So I am having
a grilled cheese. With some turkey in it. I don't really like ham. I like turkey breast. And this is regular bread. I had a leftover donut from yesterday today from Krispy Kreme. But today, it's day two. Sorry, it's still like pretty hot. It's delicious. So this morning, I realized I was like just a little bit constipated, not too much. But I, for the longest time growing up, was suffered from. Constipation, like really bad, and I never really knew why. And whenever I moved to Texas, when my diet changed, I noticed that it was kind of going away. And then, so I kind of over time figured out that gluten was probably the reason why that was happening. And so, which is why this is one of the reasons why I wanted to do the whole week of gluten again after not having any gluten for 6 months. I think I've gone 6 months without eating any gluten, and I wanted to try it again. And after one day yesterday of eating gluten, today I already noticed the difference. And so that scares me a little bit, because it was like bad before, and forever it was bad. So I figured every time that I eat something with gluten today, and from now on the rest of this week, today's just barely Tuesday, I'm just gonna drink a glass of water before I eat anything with gluten today. So we'll see how it goes. We'll see if that works. Today I had that donut, the leftover donut from yesterday. I had this like little tiny piece of hot dog because I went to Costco and I got a hot dog for my son. And so I ate just like a little small piece, so like less than half. And I ate Mexican food. It's called morisqueta, and I had that today, so that doesn't have gluten. And I had that for lunch, but now I'm eating the grilled sandwich, and it's about five. It's six, pretty much. And but I was like starving. That's another thing that I'm like always hungry since yesterday when I first had donuts. Been like starving all day. So, oh, cool. Anyways, I'll keep you guys posted. We'll see how today goes.
Another thing that I had was chocolate cake. And this cake I love. It's one of my favorite cakes, and it's from Costco, and it's this ginormous, delicious fudge, chocolate, everything cake. And I love it. And it's really big, so it lasts us a long time. But I was probably eating that cake for that whole week. I probably ate like a couple slices a day that whole week. And it was delicious, and I love it, and I always love it. I always want to go back to eating that cake because it's my favorite, and it's so good. And so I had that cake. I also had Mexican bread pretty much every day, I think, because I love Mexican bread. I love my conchas. I love, I don't know what they're called, but they're like these little square things that are kind of like cheesecake-looking things. I don't know, but I love those. So I definitely had my Mexican bread almost every single night with hot chocolate, and that's the abuelita hot chocolate. And so there we go again with the carbs and the sugar and the gluten that I was having pretty much every single night. And so the next day we went and we had lunch at Cracker Barrel. And Cracker Barrel has delicious biscuits, and they have delicious pancakes. And so I wanted to go to Cracker Barrel to get some of their biscuits. And I got some of their chicken and dumplings, which was really, really good too. I didn't get any of their pancakes this time, but I did get the biscuits, and I did get the chicken and dumplings. So That was delicious. I had that. I also had one day Cece's pizza. We like Cece's pizza, me and my husband. We pretty much like all kind of pizza. We always make our own special Cece's pizza. And it was so good. I love it. And me and my husband, we love to go there because they have the all you can eat. And we always get a specialty pizza ordered. And so that was really good. We had a good time together. And I enjoyed it, and it was good pizza. Another one of the things that I like is pasta. I really love pasta. And one of those days, I had pasta, and it's the one that's like curled, you know, or whatever. And so I had some of that pasta with Alfredo sauce, and it was so good. I love it. It tastes so good. My husband really likes that pasta too, so we enjoyed that for dinner on one of those days. So finally, I also had Whataburger. And I'm not a big fan of Whataburger. I like hardly ever eat Whataburger, but my sister likes it and she was like dying to go. So I was like, why not? Let's just go. I got there one that has the chicken strips and the barbecue sauce with like the sourdough or something. I don't know. It was really good. It was really big. I enjoyed it. It was really good. So I'm glad that we went. I'm glad that we got to go eat something that she likes and enjoy some time together. We really had a good time just being there. We never really get to do this stuff because I never want to eat that kind of food. So let me tell you, this whole week that I spent eating this delicious food, no joke, I think that after by like the third day of eating all of this delicious food that had all this gluten and sugar in it, I was done. Like, I really did not want to eat any more gluten food. And I was like trying to think, okay, what has gluten? What can I go get? What can I make? What can I eat? Just to fulfill this week. I know it sounds weird. I know it's probably something not very heard of, but I was kind of done. But I needed to finish. I wanted to finish the week, and I did. And I actually figured out something that I had trouble with for a long time, and I really didn't ever stop to put it together and see what it was. But growing up, forever until actually, I think until I was like diagnosed with the autoimmune disease, which is when I started doing the elimination diet and I started to eat better, I had like constipation problems, like really, really bad. Like always, like my mom says, even when I was a kid that I don't remember, you know, I always had constipation problems, like really, really bad. And I tried a lot of things and stuff didn't really work all the time. But, I realized, well, whenever I moved to Texas and was when I was diagnosed and I stopped eating the bad food, like that went away. And I never really knew why. I never really pieced it together. I figured that it did have something to do with the food that I was eating, but I never really paid too much attention. I was just glad that I didn't have that problem anymore. And so this week that I spent eating all this gluten, I was really constipated, like bad again. And I realized that's one of the biggest things that gluten does to me, is that it causes constipation, like really bad. And I also thought about a time where, because we don't give my son any gluten either, and he went maybe a few days eating like Mexican bread and eating regular bread whenever my mom and my sister moved in. They were giving him some of their food and he was really constipated. And I figured that it was because of the bread. That was the only thing that was different. And it was because of the bread. So he has the same thing that I have. And now that I went through this week, I was like, for sure a confirmation that's it. It's the gluten. And if for nothing else, I'm sure that for those of you who struggle with this, you would know that it is such a huge relief to not be constipated. I know that's probably TMI, but it just sucks. And so I am so glad that I was able to do that for this whole week and figure out that that is the reason Why I've been better is because of the lack of gluten in my life. And so if just for that, I will continue to do no gluten. But by the end of that week, I was also very tired. I kept getting headaches. I actually got stomach aches as well. I got really bloated. My stomach actually was like pudgy, you know, it was like coming out a little bit because I was like really bloated. And I didn't notice any like, real big difference like in my scabs, if they got worse or not, because it was just a week. I don't know if it wasn't long enough to really make a difference. But I didn't really notice a difference in my scabs. I thankfully didn't get any on like my face or my body. I still have scabs on my head. I've still been having scabs on my head for a really long time. And I haven't been able to get rid of those. But I did cut my hair to help them out. And it did help. It helped a lot with my hair, with my scabs. I mean, so that's great. Thank you guys for watching my video. Please like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on all my new videos. This is your girl, Gabby. Till next time.